Hello everyone, my name is Vijayan Sharma and I am from the School of Education, B.Ed course bearing roll number 200135, and for this exhibition in Science and Technology, I would like to present a robotic model based on artificial intelligence. As you can see, the topic of my model is human voice control for robots by using artificial intelligence. So as you can see in my hand, this is a robot that I have developed. This robot will operate based on the voice command given by the user. What I have done, I have made an Android app in my phone, and with that Android app I will connect this robot with the phone, and in this phone if I say the command like go forward, then this robot will move forward. If I say go backwards, then this robot will move backward. If I say left, then this robot will turn left, and if I say right, then this robot will turn right. That means, based on the voice command that I am giving through my phone to this robot will operate like that. Whatever command I am giving to the robot, that robot will follow that command. Means if I say forward, it will go forward, and if I say backward, it will go backward. Similarly for left and right. So this kind of implementation on a hardware, where the hardware is following the human voice command, it is an application of artificial intelligence, and I will display this model for this science exhibition. So in the upcoming part of this video, I will show you the working of this model. And the phone that I am using, means the Android app that I have developed in my phone, that phone will be connected to this robot by using a Bluetooth module. You can see this is the Bluetooth antenna, and from this the mobile phone will be operated. So I will show you in the upcoming videos how it is done.
So as you can see in this close-up view, this is my microprocessor board. This microprocessor board has the microcontroller and the microprocessors that are used for controlling the activities of the robot. This is the USB port by which I give the commands and write the programs for this robot. Everything is done by writing the computer codes, and that computer code is loaded into this microprocessor through this USB port. This black strip that you are seeing, this is the microcontroller. These are the batteries. This battery is for controlling the microprocessor, and these batteries are for controlling my motors, that is the DC motors that will be used for giving the power to the wheel. Again, as you can see this one, this is my motor control shield. This contains the MOSFET and the transistors that are used for giving the forward and the reverse motion to the wheels. So according to the signal given to this motor control shield, this motor control, the MOSFET and the transistor gives the signal to the DC motors, and the wheels turns accordingly. And as you can see this one, this the front that you can see, this one, this structure, let me show you nicely. Yeah, this one, this is the Bluetooth antenna. This Bluetooth antenna is used for connecting this robot with the mobile phone, where I will use the Android app and give the human voice commands like go forward and go backward. So this is the overall layout of my robotic model. As you can see, the wires are there. These wires are input and output wires that control the different modules of my robot, the different input and output devices. Just like a computer has a motherboard in which there are all input, output and processing devices attached, in my robotic model also, this board is called Arduino Uno. This board is the motherboard of my robot, and this controls all the input, output and processing units of my robot. As you can see, these are the wheels that will turn the robot, and beneath that you can see the motors that will be used for giving the motion to the robot. As you can see, yeah, this yellow, wait, let me show you nicely. This yellow part, as you can see, this yellow part is the DC motors that will control the wheels, and the wires are used for giving the powers to the DC motor. So now I will show you the working demonstration of this model, that how it is working and what are the applications that we can use this for. Now, in order to switch on my robot for the operations and for the human voice control, I have to give power to this robot. So for giving the power, as you can see, there are batteries, the blue color cap that you can see, this one, these are the batteries. So I will connect the batteries with the microcontroller like this. I'm connecting the battery. As you can see, as the microcontroller has got the power, the light started to glow. Also in the front, you can see the red light glowing, that is the power is going to the Bluetooth antenna also. Now the next what I will do, I will give power to the DC motors also. Like this, I gave the power to the DC motors by connecting these two. Now the power to the DC motor has also been given, and you can see the red light is glowing. So now the robot has got the power and it is in active state to receive the signals, and as soon as the signal will be given, it will start to operate and follow the commands, the human voice commands. So let's see how it will be done. Now my mobile phone has been connected to the robotic module. Now as I will give the command from my phone, the robot will operate. As you can see my phone, it is written Arduino voice control, click to speak, connected by the Bluetooth. So this Arduino has been, means Arduino means the robotic module, that Arduino robotic module has been connected to my phone, and I will give my voice command through this Android app that I have developed. Go forward. Backward. So as you can see, by simply giving the commands, the robotic module is following. Let me show you more nicely. See. Go forward. Go backward. Backward. Go forward. Backward. Backward. Left. Right. Right. Left. Left. Go forward. Backward. So as you can see, if I am giving the commands from my Android phone, the commands are getting followed in the robotic module. So this is how an artificial intelligence human voice command is working. We are giving the commands in the human voice, but the robot is following the instructions and carrying out the commands given out by the user. So this kind of application can be further used in the fields like more sophisticated technologies. For example, if we put this technology on a wheelchair, and suppose a person who is not able to walk, he can simply just give the voice command like go forward, the wheelchair will take him forward. Go backwards, the wheelchair will take him backwards. So instead of putting this technology on a robotic module, we can put the same technology, the same software on a wheelchair, and the person sitting on the wheelchair, by just simply giving the voice command, can control his locomotion. So this is an amazing technology where, by using the human voice control and artificial intelligence, I am controlling a hardware, that is a robotic module, a hardware, by using Bluetooth, Android app and a few artificial intelligence codes. So I hope you like this project. In the upcoming videos, I will show you how this program is written in the computer and how the program is loaded into the robotic module. Thank you.